Good morning. Good morning, everyone. How are you on this radiant Thursday? I'm here just in the very beautiful surrounds. You can't see it in my car. Maybe you can see here the beautiful surrounds in the bush of the very unique community art center that we have here on beautiful Bribie. It's where I run my yoga classes on a Tuesday and Thursday. And if you don't mind knowing me, I'm Beks Thompson, and I'm the one who helps women reach their highest potential without burnout, without compromising your well-being, and without compromising your feminine. And one of the things I wanted to talk to you, well, the main thing I wanted to talk to you today about is this thing around self-care, because it's such a big buzzword. It's a huge thing that we talk about. Hey, Katerina. And if we're not careful, we could be self-caring ourselves to sleep. Now, what do I mean by that? I'm going to explain that in a moment. And I nearly got caught in this yesterday, of self-caring ourselves to sleep. I mean, self-caring yourself asleep to your desires, asleep to your passion, asleep to your energy. Because self-care in some circles can be a very passive thing, or a very calming thing. And we need that, right? We need that at times, because our nervous system can be overwhelmed and on high wire, and our resting stress state can be high. So I'm all for self-care that is cognitive, that is aware, and is really tapping into our highest needs. So, you know, we have restorative yoga, we have yoga nidras, we have, mantra, meditation, lots of things we can do around self-care, spending time in nature, spending time, you know, connecting with others. But what can happen in our day-to-day human beingness is that we say things like, oh, I'm a bit tired, I don't really feel like it. And the excuse is self-care. I'm going to give myself a night in. I'm going to treat myself to this because I'm tired, or because I've been working really hard. And what happens in that moment is that we can go from doing something that is really going to uplift us and restore us to instead doing something that is going to squash our energy, suppress our desire, and stop us from really feeling what we're feeling. Now, this is a hard one. You could spend your whole life just discerning what is the ego mind self-care and what is the highest self-care. And, you know, I slip in and out of it myself at times. You know, there are times when I want to give myself a night in, and I know that I really need to be out there, because here's the thing. Your environment is what tends to lift you up. Now, whether that's your inner environment and your energy, yes, but also your outer environment. And if you stay too much in just your, say, home and familiar environment, you won't get the growth that you want. Rather than joining yourself to a community or to a tribe, or getting yourself out there and connecting with others, because that is where we really get to lift up. And so this was a perfect example yesterday. You may know that I have a Facebook group and a meetup group called the Radiant Femmes Movement, which is amazing. It is all about connection and networking and supporting each other to shine. And, you know, I was running that last night and I didn't really feel like it. It's been full moon. It's been really windy. I haven't had a night where I've not been working for a few nights. And I just really felt like a night in. You know, the numbers weren't huge because we had a lot of people pulling out, probably for the same reasons. They were feeling different things. There was people with drama in their lives, so it was going to be a small group. But I had to go. It's my commitment to showing up. But if I hadn't been running the event, I may have said to myself, oh, Bex, don't bother going. You know, you just need a night in. You did a networking event yesterday. You've been working for the last few nights. Just read, just do some singing, you know, do your meditation, and that's what you need. And yet the universe obviously organized that I needed to go, because I wanted to show up for my tribe and show up for my peeps. And with the small intimate group that we ended up having, we had a fantastic time. I got to do an experience with them and run something that I wouldn't have been able to do with a bigger group. I knew that I was feeling a little bit flat, so I made an extra effort to kind of really tap into my energy and feel gratitude that I get to do this and I get to hold this space for women that really need that connection and that love coming. And so I changed that have to in a I get to, which thank you for Loz, who is in our Radiant Femmes Online, because she just tweaked that and reminded me about that change of when you have the energy of I have to do something and you change it to I get to do something, it all changes. So I used that yesterday. Thanks, Loz. And it just changed everything. We had a fantastic night of connection and laughter and powerful tools around how we embody energy in our bodies and how we're perceived. And the amazing Francesca Moy, who was up from Brisbane, radiant, positive, and inspiring, was just amazing around stepping up and doing this, you know, social media, not being invisible, being real, sharing what's going on. So it was fantastic. I came away feeling super inspired, new connections. We had a few new people in the group. We've created some more exciting buzz and exciting plans for our Christmas party on December the 9th. So if you are wanting to connect with a bunch of really raw, really real, super vibrant women, then get yourself along to our next meetup on December the 9th. We've just opened the tickets now and half those free tickets have already gone. So get yourself in there. And it was just a great night. I'm feeling re-energized and re-inspired today. So the message is, don't suppress what you're feeling with your self-care. Don't over wrap yourself in cotton wool. Sometimes what you need is to just get yourself out into a different environment, an environment that lifts and inspires and brings that energy in. That is what we need. Yeah, you can do that internally and inspire yourself with your, you know, meditation and tools, and I strongly suggest that. But watch yourself. Do you have a habit of doing that and you need to get out more? Yeah, sometimes it's the other way around. You're out there all the time and you actually need some inner time. Yeah, and you need to be able to know, understand how to manage your energy as well when you are in a group, which is one of the most powerful things that I teach, that no matter where you are, we do need to be able to manage our own energy so that we get the lifts and we don't get the drains from being around other people. So if you want to know more about that, how to manage your energy, if you have any questions, then PM me. This is my area of expertise. I love it, helping us to just be super aware of how we can make the impact that we want, that we can shine without burnout, and all the little tricks and tips and blind spots that we can come across along the way. So I'm going to sign off now. Have an amazing day. Thank you, those that are watching. And let me know any comments of what your tendencies are, what you notice about yourself, and what you notice about the self-care that you do and when you get out and about. Love, love, love being surrounded by amazing women. All right, my lovelies, have an incredible day and a weekend if we don't see you before. Take care.